This JSON formatting sample will make your life much easier when managing news in SharePoint. It'll let you easily promote and demote news so that you can quickly control what's displayed on your intranet or on any other news feed you've got. It's so easy to implement as well. Let's get into it. Now, one of the interesting things about using this particular JSON sample that is free, I'll show you all about this thing, but it's going to use all of the default columns that come with SharePoint. You don't have to add columns. You don't have to deal with any of this. You're just going to show a new column and we're going to be customizing that one. So we're just here on my sample homepage. I've got a news feed right here to show all the latest news. Well, you know, we're in November now, and the October news is still here. I want to get rid of this thing. It doesn't need to show anymore. Now, you can, you know, in the past, you would have to, you know, do some other things to try and like hide this, maybe change filters on your news feed so it's only showing, you know, a certain number of articles. It was more complicated to do that. We're going to clean all this up. We're going to make it extremely simple, not just for you as a site admin or a site owner, but the site members, the people, the members themselves who are managing all this stuff, you'll be able to do it as those people as well. So this is really for anyone who's managing news. They can set this thing up easily and their life will be made much easier. So we're going to switch over to the site pages library. We've got our news articles and some other pages as well. I've got a draft item here for December because this isn't ready to go live yet because it's still November. But we've got October and November. I don't want to delete October news because I don't know, maybe I need this at some other point, or maybe someone wants to go back at some point and search for the October news to see what was there while they were on vacation maybe. So we can't delete this, but what we're going to do is we're going to implement this JSON sample. So the first thing we need to do is show a column that's normally hidden. Now you can click on add column and you can go to show or hide columns, or you know, there's many other ways. It's a Microsoft product after all. There's many other ways to get to it. You can click on this and show or hide columns. They all take you to the same place. You can edit the view as well if you want to edit the view and do it that way. But we're going to be showing the promoted state column. This is what is determining whether something is promoted to a news feed essentially. So we're gonna put the checkbox in that and click apply. Now we see our promoted state. Now it's just a number. It doesn't really mean anything to anyone. That's why it's hidden to begin with. But we're gonna be making some sense of this. So what we're gonna do is I'm going to show you this sample here. This is the JSON sample. It was created by some members of the community just to showcase them. It was Tetsuya Kawahara and Corey Schwartz. And they created this. It's actually several years old and they updated it since then. So they continue to maintain it. You'll see a lot of information here of what this thing is going to actually look like and how to use it. But I'll walk you through this process as well. So what we're going to do is we're going to click on this JSON file. This is the JSON code itself, the formatter. You'll see a copy raw file button right here. We're going to click this. That copies it into our clipboard. Then we go back here and we need to apply this formatter to the column. Now, don't worry about all this mess. I'm actually going to walk you through what all this stuff does. But first, we're going to actually look just see what this thing looks like. So we go down to column settings, format this column. And we'll go down to advanced mode because that's the only way you can get to the code part here. We can select all of this and delete it. And then we're gonna paste in all of that stuff. Whatever all that stuff is, we're pasting it in and we're gonna click save. So now we can click the X once we've saved it. And we'll see this. We can make the column a little bit wider, clean this up a little bit. And you'll see that, you know, it's still showing the number. We will fix that. I'm not a big fan of showing the numeric value because, again, it doesn't really mean much to me. I just want to know if it's a page, if it's news, if it's a draft, things like that. So we're going to clean this up. But what this has done is it gives you a better indicator of what type of content this is, page news, and you know, draft file. And then here's the best part. Here's really the reason why you apply this. If we are looking at November and October news on the homepage, we want to get rid of October, but not delete it. then what we can do is there's these ellipsis buttons right here. We can click on this, and the formatter gives us a context menu for this. We can say demote, change it to a page. Now, October News is showing as a page. If we refresh the homepage, now we just see November. It's really, really great. The other thing, maybe you do this by accident. You want to switch it back to a news page. Well, if we click it again for the October file, now it's promote. So we can promote it back to news. So now it's changed to a status of news. We can refresh this and we'll see October is back. So two clicks. That's really all it takes once this thing's implemented, two clicks, and you can start showing and hiding things and really get this news feed to look exactly the way you want it to look. It's really, really simple. Now, the one thing you will need to do is you notice there's the draft icon here. Now, what you'll have to do once you toggle the state one way or another, either promote or demote, is you'll have to republish the file. Otherwise, while it's showing up for you, it won't show up for everybody else. It'll be a draft copy, a minor revision or minor version, however you want to word that. And so you have to republish once you change the state. That way everyone sees basically the changes. So it's really, really simple, but let's take a look at what this thing's actually going to be doing. This isn't very much JSON actually. I've definitely shown some larger samples, but let's quickly look through what this thing does, how it does it, and we'll be able to use this information to change this, to change the look of this. Because again, I don't like the number. I think we can get rid of the number and the colon. So we're going to walk through the code and we'll go right back here and we'll change this to kind of clean it up even more. So this is a column formatter. There's view formatters, there's column formatters. And all this is really going to start doing is creating HTML elements. This is creating a div HTML element, setting a little bit of CSS so that it will start to display things in line in a row. That's why you'll see a flex direction row here. You'll see it's going to create under children. So inside this div, it's going to create children. The first one's going to be a div. And that is where we are getting the text inside that button. We'll see that if it's a, depending on the value of that field, because it's a numeric value, it'll either be 0 page, it'll be 1 news unpublished, or 2 news. So there's the text that we're going to go back and change to get rid of the number and the colon and the spaces in there as well, just to give it a cleaner look. It's setting some additional CSS properties to actually make that button look that we have here with the rounded corners and everything. So that's all done right here. Then it's doing some additional things. It's setting the background color using some of the Microsoft style classes that are available. So depending on the status or the value, We it'll either be white, gray, a light dark gray, or a light gray. So that's how we'll get that, is with this attributes and setting the CSS class based on, again, the value of that numeric field. Then there's a div that's created. And that's how we get our three dots. You see under the attributes, we're setting the icon name to more vertical. That is the three vertical dots here. So that's how we get the button that we click for the context menu. And then on that element, we're using custom card props. Now, this may look really complex and you may be thinking, hey, I'm not a coder, I'm not a developer, I can't possibly learn this stuff. I completely understand where you're coming from, but you don't even have to be a developer for this. I actually created an online course to teach you how this works. If you're interested, I've got a link in the description. It'll really help you out, but let's just keep going through this and see how this custom card props works. So what this custom card props is actually going to do is it's just going to pop up that little, really a card, isn't it? It's kind of a context menu, but in the JSON formatting terminology world, it's just called a card. So it's going to pop out that card And depending on the value, it'll either be promote or demote. So that's just setting the text that we see when that card pops out. And then some additional things to kind of position it right, make sure that we can open this up when the three dots are clicked. We have the open on event. We have some of these things, CSS styles to set the padding. So again, kind of positioning it within that card the way it needs to be presented, making sure we have a pointer as well, as opposed to normally if you put your cursor over text, you have that little I-beam like you're going to be editing text. So this just changes it to a cursor so that the users know, hey, this can be clicked on. Setting the background color here, again, using the Microsoft styles so that when we hover over the item, it will change color. Again, letting the user know that this can be clicked on. And then the final thing, kind of another little fancy thing that this does is to trigger a special action when it's clicked on, there is custom row action. And then the action is to set a value. This is actually, the way this works is it will actually set the value of that field when you click it. And then if the field is 0, it'll change it to a 2, which would be a news post. Otherwise, it changes it to 0, which would be a site page. So that's how it kind of toggles back and forth. You're literally changing the metadata value on the file when you click on it. That's actually how it works. And I've got other videos in my playlist that shows more examples of like using the custom card props or using custom row action to set values just with a click of a button without having to open up the details pane and things like that. So that's really how this JSON formatter works with a very small amount of understanding of HTML divs and some other, a few other tags. You can definitely start to customize this thing. But what we want to do is let's just go back and change this because I want to get rid of the number and the colon. So to update this thing again, so that we can clean this up, we're going to go to hit the drop-down menu for that header, that column header. Go to column settings, format this column, and we are still in the advanced mode. And here's the line that I pointed out before where we're getting all that text from, this text content field. What we can do is just start deleting the parts of that we don't want. So I'm deleting the number, the colon, and those spaces to give a really clean look. It'll just be page, news unpublished, or news. So if we were to click, now if you want to, if you're not sure if you're going to break something or not, we can click on preview just to make sure that the interface looks right. But that looks good. Now we can click save. And once we click save, we can close this. And now we have that cleaner look. So you may like this more than the original style where it shows the numbers. End users will probably like this kind of format a little bit better as well. So definitely try this out in your environment and see how this looks. I think it's a big quality of life improvement for people who are maintaining news on a department site or an intranet homepage, anywhere like that where you're having to, show or hide news and they don't want to deal with other methods like changing the KQL statements or anything like that. Now, there's so many of these free JSON samples that you could use to level up your list and libraries. I've got a playlist that shows all of these in just back to back. So just click or tap the screen to see more great solutions that you can implement for free.